This video covers the calculations required to perform magnification calibration using the cross-grating replica, and later we'll be working with Latex Spheres. When we perform a calibration, we want to be sure to measure as many squares as possible, and we only want to work with entire squares. We don't want to interpolate between the end of one or in the middle of one. So I'm going to start from the first full square, and I measure from the beginning of one square, and I'll measure to the beginning of another square at the far end. Be sure not to measure at the beginning of one to the end of the other, otherwise that introduces an error. And then besides that, I also need to be sure to count the number of squares that I'm doing, because our calculation is going to be the distance that was measured on my image or on the monitor, and that turned out to be 284 millimeters, and I'm going to multiply that by the 2160 lines per millimeter that our standard has. And the final part is to divide that by the number of squares that I counted, and I get 51,120 magnification. So now besides that, since this is a cross grating, I can also measure in the vertical direction. And that's the nice thing about having the cross grating. So here I'm going to measure from the bottom to the top, and sorry, my ruler's off the screen there. And as I measure that, I end up with 195 millimeters. So just like in my horizontal calculations, I'm going to put in my distance that I measured, 195 millimeters, times the 2160 lines per millimeter that the standard contains. And I'm going to divide that by the number of squares that I had. So now that's 52,650. If I perform an error, that I get about 2.9% error difference between the horizontal and the vertical. Now, since I've done the horizontal and the vertical, I can also check my scale bar on the image. And that's usually what people use as to determine how big the image is, and hopefully your scale bar is calibrated correctly. So just like I did with the squares, I want to start at the beginning of the one square to the beginning of the next. And I measured that to be 105 millimeters. And I'm going to divide that by the indicated magnification of 2 microns. And so I'm using 0.002 millimeters. I could have done 105,000 microns divided by 2, and I would have gotten the same number of 52,500 magnification. Now we realize that agrees very much with my vertical magnification that I received earlier. Now sometimes when you're calibrating your magnification on the microscope at a digital image acquisition, it's going to want you to put in a distance of where you measure. And so each square, if I take 1 and divide it by 2160, I get 0.463 microns. And so when I measured my first magnification calibration measurement, which was our 12 different squares across the top, how far is that in real world time? So if I were to put a marker at one end and put the marker at the 12th, what would I put in for the length? I would put in 0.463 microns times the 12, the number of squares that I measured, and that would equal 5.56 microns, so a little over 5.5 microns. Now, does that make sense from there to there? Well, if I take a look at my indicated magnification down below, I'll see that the magnification bar, which was about 4.5 squares, indicated that was 2 microns. And so if I multiply that by 2, and that was only 4.5 squares, and I measured 12 before, it comes out to be pretty good. We also have samples that have latex spheres on them. And when I measure latex spheres, I want to be sure that I don't measure spheres that are intersecting with others and not be able to get a good measurement of the diameter. So I'm going to pick ones that I can have a good measurement of the diameter. You want to be pretty as precise as you can. So that was 11. That was 12. I'm going to measure a couple more because you would like to get good average. That was an 11. And then that one is a little bit smaller. That's just 10. So if I take those and measure them, that's at an average of 11. So I'm going to take that and do the actual size as a measured divided by the actual calculated magnification, and I get about a 1.96 error.